Hello everyone, welcome back to Chen Design Channel. Today we're going to talk about how to build this eyewear and make it into the prototype and what you need to concern. I will show you a couple different ways to make eyewear. Are you ready? Let's get started. I have this eyewear template ready for you to download. This is gonna be in Rhino 5 file, so you can sign up the newsletter and download it. There's a link in the description. Once you click the link, it will ask you to sign up the description, and then you can download the file. This is a template that I draw. If you wanted to know more in the detail, you can go to the website and type it eyewear spec drawing. Usually they will give you the parts about the eyewear and things like that, and then you can trace over those lines if you like to. But I have one for you ready. All you need to do is download. Okay, so we are going to create a standard eyewear. I'm going to show you two ways to build it. Before we build this, we need to understand there are some terminology term for the eyewear. Let's go over with some parts name here so we all understand what I'm talking about in the tutorial. Right here at this space, this is called bridge, and then you have the frame, and also you have the lenses, and you also have the temple. Inside of the temple, you're going to have the hinge part, and then you're going to have the nose piece, and also at the end you have an earpiece. There are a lot more names on the eyewear, but we're simply just gonna use those. And before we build that, we also need to know our face is not flat. So your eyewear cannot just using this and extrude it. You could, it will look really stiff. We will have the eyewear follow the curvature of our face. However, there are a few different what we call curve base. Depends on how much of a curvature that is. Those information can also be found online. You have basic 2, 6, 8. The higher number, the more wraparound that's going to be, like Oakley eyewear, those kind of sporting eyewear. Most of the optical is more flat in around 2. So we are going to have that in mind for the design. I'm going to just make it optical eyewear. Okay, so now with this template, there are two ways that we can do that. First way to build, if something is really curved like Oakley eyewear, we may want to build a sphere first, and that will be indicate your head, right? You can decide what curvature that you wanted, decide what is the head size and everything. And basically what you can do is you go into the front view, you pick up your frame, and then you want to project it to the sphere. Let's use the project to the sphere. Then once you have it there, we're gonna use that to trim off the extra that we needed. So we will have this something really wrap around, right? To make it into the thickness, since this is, we don't need this in the back. And since we already have the surface, we could basically just offset the surface for whatever thickness that's going to be. I'm gonna set it up for 3, and we can quickly just get something like this, right? We need a lot more dimension on it. You're gonna go into building the thickness on the certain part. If you like this and that will work for you, one way that you can also change the thickness is by giving the commands called cage edit. You're gonna choose the bounding box, and we need a lot more control point instead of just like that. So I'm going to set it up for 16 here for the X. For the Y, I'm going to set it up for 6, and Z, we are going to set it up for 6. Okay, so now I have all this point right there. For example, I'm going to make the nose piece more pronounced. I'm gonna come over here, select those. I'm going to come over here, select those point, and I can pull it up. And then so I can kind of changing the thickness that I want. If I need something right here in the middle, I might need more point. All right. So this is something to quickly to get the idea for the eyewear, to get it into the certain form. However, it may not be the best way to accurately model it, since whenever you pull this, it might change how the lens is going to fit. Okay, so if you want to just getting a concept really quick, that might be something that you can play with. The way I'm going to build the eyewear is going to be like that. On the top in your template, you also can have this basic base that you have. We are going to make sure it's a closed curve, and we are going to do something like this. We're gonna pick up our eyewear and let's go ahead to extrude it into a solid like this. We also going to extrude this one into a solid like this. Okay, so all we need to do now is to bowling intersect, and we'll pick up those two set, and then we'll have an eyewear over here. I'm going to move this eyewear to this point. All right, so that will be fitting to where our tempo is going to be. Now we have this, and I need to have the bridge coming up, right? So I need to have those line on my eyewear. So I'm gonna have those two line and project it to the surface right there. Okay, so those lines going to be the line helping me to creating more of the shape. Let's explode it, and we just want to keep it those two line, and let me change into the green color. Alright, so those are the line I'm going to play with. Let's go ahead to creating the arc. Gonna snapping into the endpoint here and another endpoint here. Let's take a look on the top view and see how pronounced we want that piece coming out, and it's gonna come out like this. I'm also gonna snap into the bottom, have it coming out similar way like this. Okay, so now we have those here, and we are going to create that surface by going to the sweep tool, rail one, rail two, going from the line and this curve here. So that's how we get this piece here. So for the next step, not only I will need to fill up the gap, flush it, and also I need to have the fillet on the edges. If we do not have this piece, it could be really easy to fillet on the edges, but a lot of time the fillet happen having arrow is usually when you have those point right there. So to avoid that, we need to take a few more steps before we getting in there. A lot of people are having issue on the fitted edges. So I'm going to show you why and how do you avoid. I'm going to make this eyewear a copy, and let's just put it next to it. On the first one, we all like to take the outline and to trim this middle bridge first. Once we trim it, we're going to have them all joined together. Okay, once we have that, we can go ahead to do a fillet. Let's go ahead to use the fillet surface. We are gonna do 7, which is pretty big, and so you will have a nice look there. Okay, the second one I'm going to do is I'm gonna do the fillet first. Once I have everybody, I'm going to join it. Then I'm coming to the front view. I'm going to pick up my edge and trim the extra. Okay, so now let's do a comparison. It appeared to be almost similar, and then we can fill it the top and the bottom, but notice that I want you to pay attention right here on the edge. So it's followed the curve nicely. It's because we fit it and trim later. Now, if you look at this one, you might notice that where the fillet, it become a straight line there. This is what happened when we try to trim it first and then fill it later. And what is matter in between those two? Let's go to the next step. We're going to duplicate it, all the edges right here. And make sure you join together. The same thing is gonna happen here, and we're gonna duplicate all the edges. And make sure you join together. That's creating the surface right here. Using the sweep tool, Okay, so now let's join everybody together. So they all become the closed solid poly surface, as you can see on my property, right? So now this is a huge difference. When we try to fillet the edges, we are going to use the same fillet. I'm going to use the radius for 1, and let's go ahead to fillet all the way to the end on that part, all right? And then we're gonna do the same way. We're gonna fillet this one. We're gonna do all the way the same to the end. Then let's take a look on this one. In our property, this one is showing the open poly surface. Where does it break? Let's take a look on this one. If we use the analyze and then you have edge tool and then you wanna show edge and then you show this one, it have the break right here. That is exactly where we were doing the fillet edges on the surface earlier. And this one right here, it doesn't have any naked edges. And the reason is the step. That's a very tiny difference on the modeling process, but it actually makes a huge difference so you don't have to fix all the problem. So now we have the frame, we want to go ahead to fillet the edges on all of them. Always make sure each step they are closed solid poly surface, and let's take a look on the render and see if everything look nice and smooth for you. Okay, this is gonna be the prototype. We are going to print it out and we'll put the lens in there. If you are able to access the laser cut, you can laser cut the lens, but we need to make a groove for the lens to sit in. This is how we are going to do. We are going to use the commands called twin curve, and then we are going to select this curve here or the edges right there. And then you want to set up the numbers 1, you just want something right in the middle. We want to move in this point to the middle, and then that's how we get this curve right there. This is allow us to make a channel, so we're going to have a pipe there, and I'm going to set it up for 0.85 as my radius. Then I will have this one. Since it is a symmetrical eyewear design, so I'm just simply gonna mirror to the other side. Then we can use the bowling difference. Have that one difference out by those two pipes. So now we have this channel here. Let's take a look on the render so we can pop our lens in there. Again, depends on how thick your lens is and you can make adjust the channel there. Next video, we are going to work on the nose piece and also the temple. Thank you for watching and I will see you next time.